right, so to demonstrate buoyancy, let's take this canister. Now we're going to show that this floats. Clearly floats. Why does it float? It floats because it has a mass of 16.3 grams and a volume of 256.4 centimeters cubed. By definition, density is equal to mass divided by volume, and the density of this canister is 0.064 grams per milliliter, which is less than water's density, which is 1 gram per milliliter, and therefore it floats.
Go.
All right, so now we'd like to demonstrate a case where the canister will not float, as we have weights of various masses inside of this canister, and the overall mass of the canister and the weights is equal to 276 grams, which is greater than the volume of 256.4 centimeters cubed. Therefore, this density will come out to be greater than 1, which is greater than the density of water, which is 1 gram per milliliter. So therefore, it should sink. Let's take a look.
Oh my God!
Oh my God.
All right, I'm back again in a different outfit. But today we'd like to understand and explain Archimedes' principle, aka buoyancy. Well, here, thanks to Archimedes, we understand the buoyant force is equal to the density of the fluid times the volume of the fluid times the force of gravity, which in our case, gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared. The density of water would be 1 kilogram per liter. And in this case, we took 1 liter of water. And when you go through the calculations, you find out the buoyant force for this turns out to be 9.8 newtons, which translates to a force of 9.8 newtons is needed to displace 1 liter of water to allow said object to float. All right, so let's take this equation and apply it to a real life example. In Western New York, there are the Finger Lakes and the Great Lakes. There's a lot of fishing. So let's take a small fishing boat. Let's say its mass is 100 kilograms. The weight of this, which is just the mass times the force of gravity, which in this case is 9.8 meters per second squared, is equal to 980 newtons, which means basically it's being pushed down on the water, if you want to think of that, with that large force. So will a boat of this size float? Well, using Archimedes' principle, we have the density of the fluid is 1 kilogram per liter. The gravity, force of gravity, stays the same as 9.8 meters per second squared. But to achieve the force of 980 newtons, which we need to have 100 liters of water here, aka this translates to 980 newtons are needed to displace 100 liters of water so that this ship will float. If it doesn't achieve that, well, it's not floating. All right, so the first real submarine used in action was called the Turtle, invented by David Bushnell, a student studying at Yale University in 1775 during the Revolutionary War. He invented this as a means to use to create submarine warfare. How did he do this? Well, the structure of it was about a 10-foot-tall barrel-like structure that was named for the Turtle because it had two turtle-like shells on each side. It was about 10 feet tall, only about 3 feet wide though, so it was very small. Only about one person could fit inside this compartment, and this one person was responsible for steering, diving, rising, and navigating slash propelling this craft. So it was a very tall task. And it didn't really live up to the hype. It only could go about 3 miles an hour in the steadiest of waters, let alone if there was some waves or choppiness going on. And it only had about 30 minutes of air, so long expeditions were pretty much useless. And most of the time, it couldn't even submerge. It just had to float at the surface unless it was actually performing an operation. And during even the operations, it didn't work well. One of its first pilot runs was conducted by Sergeant Ezra Lee, who volunteered to pilot it. On his first attempt to sink the British ship, the Eagle, he had dug down under the ship and was preparing to dig into the hull. Now, the hull is made of iron, so as you can see, underwater and in a craft where he has to continuously navigate and keep the ship in one place and dig into it at the same time, it was not easy. Eventually, he gave up and tried again. However, this time he had trouble keeping the actual Turtle, the submarine, stay steady in one spot during the time. So he eventually failed and gave up and just released the mine and let it explode in the water, which caused the British ships to go away. Why is this important, you may ask? Well, it actually paved the way for the way modern submarines work. In Bushnell's model, underneath him in the hull, there was a small compartment where he would allow water to fill in order to let the boat dive. The math and physics behind this is the fact that now the original water that would be displaced, that would be pushing up on the barrel, is now going back into the barrel itself, which lowers the volume of water displaced in the buoyancy equation thanks to Archimedes, which basically means that you're not getting the force that you need to stay afloat, which means you're going to sink. And to counter that, when you want to rise up, a hand pump operated by the operator would push out the extra water and cause that displaced water to again return to its normal number and push you back up to the surface slowly.
Thank you.